Now, how do you figure out how much to charge? How much cash should I charge you? How much cash should I charge you? How much cash should I charge you? Basically, we're going to try to figure out what the carrying value or the amortized cost should be. In this case, it's 1,000 net of 100 is 900, which happens to be the cash. Here it happens to be 1,000, which is 1,000. Here it happens to be 1,000,001, which is this plus this. Okay, there could be other factors that fall into that, but we've got to figure out, okay, how much should the present value of the bonds be? When you're present valuing the bonds, there are two things we need to present value. We need to present value the face, and we need to present value the interest. Now let's think about it. The $1,000,000 is what? Some amount you're going to be getting down the road. So what we need to do is, you know, $1,000,000 today is worth more than $1,000,000 in 5 years. So what we're going to do is we're going to have to figure out the $1,000,000 value, the present value in 5 years, because that's what I'm going to give you, plus the present value of the 80 you're getting for 5 years. That means we're present valuing two things. We're present valuing the face as a lump sum. We're present valuing the 80. When you have an equal amount to be received or paid, that's called an annuity. So what we have to do is present value the annuity to see what that value is. When you add those two up, that's how much we should charge you. So let's think about it. When I'm looking at the $1,000,000, so here's the face, the present value of the face or the par value, and that would be the $1,000,000 times, what was the stated rate? The stated rate was 8% equals 80,000, and that is the interest. So we have to present value two things, the face and the interest. The face will be a lump sum, the interest will be what? The interest will be an annuity, an equal amount to be received or paid. In this case, 8% of $1,000,000. So we use the stated rate to figure out the cash. So we're going to take the $1,000,000 times the present value of a lump sum in 5 years at what percent? What percent do you want to earn? Let's assume it's the discount, example two. We want to earn 10%. So notice you use the effective rate to present value the lump sum. So in this case, let's say $1,000,000 present value, 5 years, 10% is this, plus what? $80,000 annuity times the present value of an ordinary annuity, and not in, but for 5 years at whatever rate you want to earn, 10%. Now notice the difference. It says present value of an ordinary annuity. We're going to learn about different types. You have an ordinary annuity. Your ordinary annuity is your arrears at the end of the year. In other words, if I buy the bond today, have I earned any interest today? No. You haven't earned the interest till what? Till the end of the year. That's called an ordinary annuity, or annuity in, where's your end? At the rear, your arrears. Uh-huh. Versus, there are certain things where, let's say your mortgage, do they say, oh yeah, or your rent, you rent an apartment, do they say, pay me at the end of the month? No, they want the money up front. That would be, excuse me, that would be an annuity due in advance, or an annuity due. And they call annuity due or annuity due now. So think of annuity due now or annuity in advance. That's when you receive or make the payment at the beginning. So for example, a lease payment you make at the beginning, a bond interest you haven't earned till the end. So in a bond, we're going to use 80,000 times the present value of an ordinary annuity for 5 years at 10%. That gives us this. This plus this equals how much we should basically charge you for the bond. That's what we're looking for. So that's what the cash proceeds should be. That is present valuing those two elements. So if you look in your notes, it says, the next consideration is how to handle, to calculate the proceeds from the issuance of the bond. It says here, to calculate the present value, two amounts, present value of the face of the bonds, face times present value of a lump sum, plus present value of the interest, which is an annuity, face times stated times time, of an ordinary annuity. Now, couple of things. The sum of these two amounts represents the present value of the bonds. If it's semi-annual, now what does semi-annual mean? It means you get interest not once a year, but every 6 months or twice a year, semi-annually. In that case, let's say it is a 5-year 8%, or let's do present value, let's do 10%, 5-year 10%. So when you're doing a present value table, instead of doing five periods at 10% and looking for the present value factor, you would do 5 times 2 is 10 periods divided by 2 at 5%. Now the difference between 5 years at 10% and 10 periods at 5% is what? The difference is a compounding interest difference. In other words, when you put money in the bank, how often does it earn interest? Every day. Compounds daily. That's why it says the interest rate is 3%, but the APY, the annual, is not 3%, but 3.0146, because it earns interest on interest. So if I put $1 million in the bank today, by the end of the day, I've earned $1,001,000. I have $1 extra. But tomorrow, I'm going to start earning interest on $1,001,000, and then $1,002,000 plus interest, $1,004,000, 6, 10, 12. That's called compounding interest. It compounds daily. Here, the difference is not a huge difference, but it's a compound interest difference, because here you're just earning interest every year. Here you earn interest on interest on interest, and that's going to be the difference in that factor. So you'll see in your notes, semi-annual, take the years times 2, the interest divided by 2. Sometimes they'll just say in the exam that the bonds were issued at 101 or 98. What does 101 or 98 mean? 101 means 101% of face, or 98% of face. Generally, not always, but generally this would be a what? Premium, because you got more money. This would be a discount because you got less. It's not always the case, because sometimes there's other things included. Maybe it's a bond with detachable stock purchase warrants, which means that you have to give some value to that stock purchase warrant, which we'll cover later. So I don't want you to say always premium, always discount. Not necessarily the case. However, it tells you how much you got. I got 101% of face, or I got 98% of face. That's how much cash I got. So those are important concepts in understanding the basics of how to calculate these amounts.